Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to this video where we're going to be taking a look at the 82 rated in-form James Maddison card. Now, as always, I love going in-depth on these player reviews, but let me know what you guys think about him in the comments below. I'm always interested to hear what you guys have to say. And if you do enjoy the video, obviously leave a like. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button as that will really help me out. So, we've seen the team that we used him in. We've seen the position that we've used Maddison in. Now we're going to have a look at his attribute details quickly. And as you can see, he's a really solid player, especially early on in FIFA, which is when he's come out. This is a really, really good card. And with the right chemistry style applied on him, you can make him an absolute world beater. You really can. He's got good pace to begin with. 79 on the acceleration, 76 on the sprint speed. For a midfielder, it's pretty solid. Obviously, you can up those areas if you want to. I chose not to. But it's pretty usable as the base card stats. So really, really decent there. His shooting column is something that I upgraded, as you can see. And I thought they were really, really good stats, especially after that upgrade. 81 on the attack positioning really stood out. Very noticeable in game. Finishing also pretty solid. And great shot power to absolutely fly past the goalkeepers. Long shots, volleys and penalties also pretty solid. His passing is exceptional. Comes out of the box with 86 vision. Crossing is also very, very good. Free kick accuracy decent. Short passing exceptional there at 85. Long passing and curve also pretty tidy. Dribbling wise, very solid. Great agility there at 87. His balance is tidy at 80. Reaction's all right there also. Ball control, very, very special at 85. It's a shame maybe he doesn't quite have the same dribbling and composure stats as he does dribbling and agility, but overall it's very, very good. When you throw in the 4-star skill moves, you have a really, really solid player on your hands. Physicality, not that brilliant. He doesn't have very good strength. He's not good aerially, but he does have okay stamina. So now that we've seen those attribute details, guys, let's jump into some in-game footage and hear what I thought about him. So currently going for between 40 and 50k, he is a little bit expensive for an 82 rated in form, but he's got a great nation, he plays in the Premier League, and he's got some incredible stats. So for me, he's definitely worth going out and spending that hard-earned coin on. He's a really, really good player in this game. I really enjoyed using him, and I think that comes across in some of the goals that I scored with him. I wasn't really trying too hard. Sometimes when you're doing a player review, you sort of force it a little bit. You put all the play through that one player so that you can get the clips. Whereas that wasn't needed with Maddison at all, because the lovely give and goes that he would do, he'd always make some really intelligent runs. And I just loved the way that he was always bombing forward. He'd get the ball, he'd lay it off with his very good passing. He's obviously got the dribbling to stay out of trouble, to get himself away from defenders, because he doesn't have any strength. When they catch up with him, that is definitely something that is a con on the card. He will get bullied off the ball. But luckily, he's got enough about him with the skill moves, with the agility, with the dribbling, the low center of gravity that he does have, so that that isn't too much of an issue overall, and something that I really didn't find a problem with. I loved his movement. I love his jinking and jiving. His dribbling was really, really good. And as I say, when the ball came into him, he found a pass and then he got on his bike and he was always bursting through the heart of the defence, and he really did score some fantastic goals. Not always goals from distance or where he's done anything too spectacular, but the movement involved was really second to none, and I thought he was absolutely brilliant. Always at the heart of attacks, making things happen for the team. He's got a good amount of pace, I think, to be honest, to carry the ball. And actually, sometimes you might want to slow it down with him. Just use that dribbling, get the head up, back the defenders away, and then you've got that range of passing. You can finesse shot it into the top corner. You can do an absolute range of things with Maddison. I really enjoyed this card. I think that's coming across in this review. I mean, yes, he is a little expensive, as I mentioned at the start, but it's early on in FIFA. There's not too many special cards out there. This guy is a really solid option. He's obviously a Premier League player, which will bump that price up a lot. But for me, what a card you were getting. And with the right chemistry style on him, as I said when we looked over the stats, and I would definitely recommend that Deadeye. Take advantage of his really good passing and shooting. He's already got good dribbling, which might be an area you want to upgrade as well. But overall, those three columns, I think, are where you need to invest with the right chemistry style on him. I don't think he needs too much more pace. There's no point putting anything into defensive or physical, in my opinion. Once you do that and you get him into the cam position, because that's, for me, maybe with centre forward is where he's going to really excel. I think he's wasted at central midfield, and obviously I wouldn't dream of playing him at CDM. Absolute waste of time in those positions. But in centre attacking mid, where he can really join and link up the attack for the whole team. He is just exceptional and a player I would highly recommend. That is why I have given him a really solid 8.7 out of 10. That is obviously a rating for the time of FIFA that this card has come out in. Yes, he is a little bit expensive at the time, but by the time there are more cards out there, he will also be a little bit cheaper, which will make his rating, for me, stand true for the rest of FIFA. I think he's a brilliant player. I'd highly recommend you go out and use him. Let me know if you've used him in the comments below. Let me know if you have any questions. I'm always happy to answer those for you. And peace!